to enter now, and then we will come to question and answers. So while, you know, we have a question and answer session at the last, but still, in case you have any question in the in between, feel free to type in the chat box, and as soon as I get into that, I'll answer that question. And to have a better audio quality, let's ensure that everybody is on mute and there is no noise, so that, you know, everybody can hear what I'm talking about, and I also get to know your questions. And I think this session is recorded as well, so you can have a, you know, look it again. Okay. So moving ahead, I'll introduce myself. As I said, my name is Nitin Gupta. I have experience of 11 years in SAP consulting, and around 19 plus projects I have done overall in SAP. FICO was my core skill. I started with FICO. Then I entered into different other areas, solution architecture. And then when SAP launched this product, S/4HANA, I was a part of first implementation globally with SAP consulting worldwide. And I was involved in the product testing. I was involved in the early knowledge transfer sessions by SAP Americas. And I am the trainer for SAP S/4HANA as well for SAP India. So I have experience of training for 7 years now in SAP. Various modules I take, FICO, S/4HANA is a core skill, central finance, new asset accounting, solution architecture, integration, project system, and new GL. And as I said, I am associated with SAP globally on different areas, on development side as well as on the new products. And I have been experienced in different other aspects of the project, not just simple implementation, like merger acquisitions, divestitures, fiscal year change, legal changes, migrations, and many more. Is my screen visible to everybody? I changed my screen.
It's still the same screen.
Yeah.
The first slide.
Okay. I don't know what happened.
Nitin, I just changed the presentation from you to me, and I now again switched it back to you. Hopefully, go ahead and share your screen now.
Sure. Let me try it again.
And can you also put it in full screen mode so that, you know, this can, yeah, now I can see.
Yep.
It's not still in full screen mode, I think. It's not in the presentation mode.
I did in the presentation mode now.
Yeah, I think that's where it probably kind of gets stuck. I'm not sure why. Can you move to the next slide? Let me see if I see any changes in the slides. Are you moving?
Yeah, I moved.
Yeah, it's still stuck in the first slide. Can you take your...
Yes, Nitin, I guess like it's not going to work on the presentation more for the GoToMeeting for some reasons. Like we had the issues on last time too. So I think we need to work it on the without the presentation regular mode.
Okay.
The design mode.
Yeah.
Let's try that. Hold on. So
this
can
is
you
working now, Nitin.
Yeah, it works. Now we can see four slides. Yeah.
Okay.
Can you quickly review what all you said with the slides so that then everyone can, you know, kind of
right,
you know, place their post.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay. So if you can see the slide now, it's about, you know, my introduction. So that's what I talk about, my experience, my projects, areas of expertise, as well as, you know, my association with SAP globally. Take a moment to go through this. That will help you, you know, to understand whom you're going to interact with when you get into the training. Okay. And I think I saw a question in the window. I'll answer that just in a couple of minutes. So give me some time. Okay. So the next slide is about introduction. I as I said, you know, it would be helpful if everybody just have a quick round of introduction, your name, location, experience, whatever experience you carry, SAP or non-SAP, doesn't matter, and what expectations you have from the session, what exactly you are looking at, so that we can help you drive, you know, the attention towards your expectations, and your goal to have, you know, spending an hour with us should be fulfilled. So if you guys can go ahead one by one. I may not call everybody's name, but you just can go ahead one by one.
Hey Nitin, this is Kunal. Actually, I'm from the Atlanta, Georgia, North America, and I'm experienced in like 11 plus years of the IVR and CTI Genesis technologies. So I'm trying to, you know, to kind of change myself in a technology world. So that's the reason I'm just found like near real interest in the SAP. I have just finished the SAP F5 sessions, the previous sessions we had with the Central, one of the trainer has provided. And my expectation is for like, you know, getting trained by S4HANA and try to, you know, get the you know, future projects for into the SAP S4HANA only.
Okay. Thank you so much, Kunal. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Anybody next volunteer? Guys, please go ahead. You know, let's make this session interactive. It should not be a hybrid session.
This is Ashoka from Harrison, New Jersey. I just completed a master's in information systems. And I have experience in both finance and IT operations from a banking industry. And I'm looking forward to learn more about S4HANA in this course. And I just took the training session for Sapphico.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yes, please. Next one.
Hi, Nathan. This is Arun from Phoenix, Arizona. I have 7 years experience in SQL in banking domain. I'm new to SAP FICO and SAP HANA. I just want to know how it works.
Okay, good. So stay tuned. You know, we'll give you the roadmap how you can get into this field. So for those people who are new, just stay tuned. You know, in the coming slide, I'll tell you how to get into this domain and enter to the real world. So we'll come to that. Thank you, Arun.
Hi,
yes.
My name is Arun.
Hello. Hi.
Yes, please, go ahead. I think you have opened your speaker as well as your headset. Okay. Yes.
Hi, this is Radhika. I'm in Houston, Texas. My background is purely finance and strategic planning, so I'm just trying to see if getting certified in S4HANA is the right step to take in my career.
Okay, great. Thank you. Yes.
Hi, this is Anand. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. And I have 12 years experience in SAP and 4.5 years in HANA. I would like to get into this FICO S4HANA and get more details on upcoming changes. That's my current goal as of now.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks, Anand. Yes. I think we have more people.
Hi. This is Gopi from Atlanta, Georgia. And my background is all mainframe programming developer, and I was part of the last class, but I had to, you know, I couldn't finish it off because I had to go to India for medical emergency. So I would like to get back to the class and continue with this, and then like to explore the opportunities. You know, what is the SAP, and what are the opportunities available going forward? So.
Okay, great. Thanks, Gopi. Yes. Yes, please. We have Ashfaq, we have Naraina.
Hi, Nitin. My system getting trouble with the headphone. Okay, let me start. I'm from New York. I work in finance almost 12 years. I want to lie in the functional part of the country, SAP or Oracle, whatever else.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So thank you so much, guys. You know, it was a pleasure to have people from different locations, different backgrounds, and, you know, good to have you guys. Thank you. So let's move ahead. As our agenda says, you know, the next is training methodology. So how we are going to conduct this training? So even this applies to both S4HANA and FICO. So the way we will take is, you know, we will have a PPTs, we will have a PDF files. So when I say PDF files, all those PDF will be the certification material for FICO as well as for S4HANA, the SAP standard certification material. PPTs will be something, you know, I have created based on my experience. Those have some real-time things, some screenshots, and of course some content from the standard training material. So those are big books. So, but of course I'll be sharing those materials to you. We will be going through the all the topics, you know, as per the course content in class, and then I'll have exercises for you so that, you know, I can ensure that what I gave you, you absorb that, and then I'll give you some home assignments as well, some question and answers to take care of you, you know, during your free time. And then in the class itself, we will be taking care of all end-to-end system configuration for FICO, for S4HANA, both the entire system configuration, what we need to do, how we need to configure each step, everything we will take care of during the class. And then for the same thing, you know, I'll give you in parts like configure these 5 items at home. Then you guys get time to practice yourself. In case you have questions, come back to me in the next class. Interview questions in class and home assignment board. So I'll give you a lot of interview questions which help you in interview, which help you in certification for both FICO as well as S4HANA, as well as will help you in preparing some process documentation, how implementation project works, how to prepare documentation, what kind of documentation are prepared, like blueprint, test scripts, and all those things. So all this will be the training methodology. We will be following these steps. So in summary, theory, all configurations, then assignment, exercises and assignments in class, exercises and assignments for your homework. And then, of course, at the last, interview questions. Interview questions, you can say Q&A, FAQs, certification questions, all those will be together. In case you have any question on any slide, feel free to type it down or make a note of it. You know, once we come to Q&A, I'll answer all the questions. Logistics. We will be meeting on GoToMeeting, and all the sessions will be recorded to facilitate. In case you are busy for some particular session, you will be able to, you know, listen to the recorded video. All training materials will be provided to you. You can download those. System access will be available. You know, when you join the training for 3 months, you will have system access. So you can, even after, let's say, we finish up training in 1.5 months, you have time to, for next 1.5 months, to practice yourself. So you will have complete system access with you. And after the training, we'll help you out with, you know, if you have any query, if you have any questions, for 1 month we can help you so that, you know, you complete your all exercises or anything you are trying to practice, you can complete that. And then Celltech will provide you the placement assistance. So that these will be the logistics. That's how we will be taking care of the material, the videos, and all the logistics which are associated with the training. Course duration for FICO is 55 hours. Now comes to S4HANA. Now in S4HANA there are 3 parts. Number one is the books S4F01, the codes. These are standard SAP certification codes. S4F01, financial accounting powered by HANA. S4F02, management accounting or CO powered by HANA. And the third one is S4F03, which is migration from ECC to S4HANA. So these courses are divided, you know, as per 35 hours. And then in case somebody is interested to have FI and CO together for on powered by HANA or the standard course, S4F01 plus S4F02. So that total will go to 60 hours. And all course content I'll show you come down in the coming slides. All course contents are aligned with standard SAP certification material. Nothing is, you know, I'm missing it out or I'm putting it extra. It is completely aligned what SAP gives you in terms of certification. You will get that. And even after the core classes, you can appear for certification. Same books I'll provide you. Course content. So let's talk about FICO first, because that's a base for S4HANA as well. So for FICO, we'll be talking about what SAP is, because for those people who are new, we will talk about SAP, the standard implementation methodology, ASAP. And then we will talk about finance and controlling. So in financial accounting, we will have enterprise structure, general ledger. accounts payables and receivables, asset accounting, bank accounting, and taxes. So these are the part of FI in FICO bucket. Coming to CO, CO is controlling or management accounting. So we'll take care of cost center accounting, internal orders, cost element, overview of COPA, and overview of product costing. And of course, integration is something which will be extra. As I said, based on my experience, I have standard, you know, the very well-defined content in terms of end-to-end process, how purchase process works, how sales process work, how the accounting happens, how configurations happen. So that we will take care in integration. FI with MM, which is materials management, FI with SD, sales and distribution, FI with CO, FI and CO integration, and then FI with HR, human resources like payroll, travel expense, how FI is integrated with other areas. And then we'll show you some standard SAP reports, how reporting works in SAP, variants creation, moving the rows and columns. So we'll work on those reporting areas. So these are the course content for FICO. S4HANA. S4F01, financial accounting, S4F02, management accounting, and S4F03, migration to S4HANA. So S4F03 is completely different. So for those who want to learn SAP, S4HANA, you should go for S4F01 and 2. For those who are very good in FICO, who understand processes, for them it is, you know, migration is suggested, because a lot of projects will be there, you know, for current companies who are there on ECC, they will migrate to HANA. So that's end-to-end migration process. 1 and 2 is completely to learn, understand what S4HANA is, how finance is changing, how CO is changing in S4HANA. It was FICO, then SAP changed it to S4HANA. Now things have changed. Now how does this work? Like if you see here, introduction to S4HANA, introduction to financials, new architecture, Fiori will give you the overview, and then process, migration process, configuration of GL, new functionalities, new asset accounting, reporting options, central finance option, and then cash management. A lot of things change here, like management accounting, integrated business planning, new architecture here, and how CO can work in S4HANA with central finance. And the third one is completely, you know, migration. If you see here, analysis of migration process, preparation and activities to be performed in system prior to migration, configuration of GL accounting for migration, configuration of assets for migration, performing migration, results of migration, and zero downtime scenario. So this is all related to migration. And that's what I showed, the duration. If you see again this slide, so this was FICO I talked about. Financial accounting, management accounting, integration, 55 hours. S4F01 and 02 are 35. In total, this goes to 60, because there are some overview content which are overlapped. So that's why the hours can come cut down here. And then we have migration for 35 hours, S4F03. Okay. Okay, so for those people who are brand new to SAP, so let's understand what is SAP. Everywhere, if you see LinkedIn, if you see different type of, you know, IT structure, you will, IT magazines and everywhere, you will see SAP is booming. So SAP is a German multinational software giant, which is today's number fourth largest software company in the world. And recently, it is awarded as the most sustainable software company in the world. So it is basically company name as well as the product name. So product, they have like SAP S4HANA, SAP FICO, SAP Ariba, all these are, main company name is SAP, system application and products and data processing, headquartered in Germany. And it provides end-to-end solution for the business management, financials, accounting, analytics, logistics, manufacturing, sales, quality management. It has solution to all the business scenarios. And for every industry, mostly, they have solution. If you talk about any industry, FMCG, retail, aerospace, manufacturing, any other industry, airline industry, distilleries, pharma, they have solution, telecom, they have solution for everybody. So if you see today, as I think the last fact I read somewhere in the magazine is out of Fortune 1000 companies, 98% are using SAP. So you can see the reach this company has, and that the, and if you can go through the website, you will see a lot of facts in SAP.com, how fast the company is growing and how fast they are innovating. So I'll come to the innovation path, what these guys have followed and how they are booming today. Okay, FICO. So we were talking about course content and demo. So, but question is, what is FI and CO? So FI means financial accounting, CO means controlling, or in accounting language, those who are from accounting background, you can understand management accounting. So financial accounting is something, you know, if I'm running a company, I have to present my financial statements, my reports, my profit and loss, my balance sheet, everything to the statutory authorities, auditors, tax, government, IRS. Whatever I am doing, I have to report it. My tax filing and everything happens. So that takes care of, comes under financial accounting. Anything which is there in the system in terms of transaction, but it is just for my purpose. I spend $1,000 of an electricity bill. $1,000 is my expense, but I need to understand which department is incurring more so that I can, if I'm trying to control my expenses, I can control, hey, you guys are switching on the lights unnecessary. Or if a travel expense, one department is traveling so much, I can get into more detail that internally, government has nothing to do with my internal financials. Which department is incurring those expenses? Nobody cares, but I care, because I have to manage my company. So that's management accounting, internally managing the business so that I can come to the strategic decisions. Okay, this product is not doing well, let's shut it down. Market is going up for this particular area, let's invest more in R&D of this particular area. All those decisions are facilitated by management accounting. So that's what we have FI and that's what we have CO. So I think those who are from non-SAP, those understand well, because I didn't talk about any SAP language here. So it was completely, you know, the simple business language. Now, those people who want to join FICO, what would be your role when you complete the training, you get the project? Now, what would you do? You go to the, to your, you know, you cleared the interview, you go to your job day one. Now, what's your job? So your job is, if you are an implementation project, your first role is to understand what the project you are working, what the company do. You have to understand the requirements. Then documentation. You have to document everything. Hey, how, today you do this, the process is in this way. In SAP, you have to do in this way. That's what I'll teach you. How processes in SAP work. Business can do it, you know, every business, every company do it in their own way. But SAP has the best practices, standard SAP is given for every industry. So I'll give you that. Configuration of the system. Now business said, hey, these are the requirements, you documented, business sign off. Now you have to configure the system. That's what we will do in training. We will configure the end-to-end system as per the requirements. Testing the system. Then after configuration, it is not just you are done. You have to test that everything you did is working fine. You test the system. Then training the business users, end users. Now your job is, for those guys, SAP is new, right? So you complete your training, your implementation, SAP goes live, you migrate everything, and now you train to the users, hey guys, now you have to post an invoice like this. You make the payment like this. You post a JV like this. If you want to run the report, run this like. If you want to shuffle the report, add more columns, do like this. Create variant. So you will do all those things to the users. And then when the project goes live, there are support projects. So support projects are like day-to-day issues comes. Something goes wrong, a business have a new requirement, company had a merger and acquisition, now the new project comes in for the same company. They said they acquired a company, now that company is on different tool, now you have to implement SAP there as well. So support the business in case of any bug, issue or request comes up, and any new requirement, as I just said, you know, the mergers happen or divestiture happens, so you have to work, and then any legal change. Government changes time to time legally, you know, a lot of things. So the good example, if you guys are aware, in 2014, Malaysia changed the tax regime. They implemented GST. This year, India is going to change the entire tax structure. Now, every company in India which is on SAP will have a project, because those guys are follow the standard, whatever the tax structure is. But now, in coming months, everything will change. So every company will have a project. You have to implement GST. So it's not that once it is done, it is done. You have opportunities coming in and in. So that would be your role as a FICU consultant. It applies to S/4HANA as well. But since S/4HANA is something, you know, if things goes in the same fashion, but only I'm just focusing on here, because those people who are new to SAP, they need to understand what exactly they will do when they enter, they complete the training. Because it is easy to join the training, but the question is, once you complete the training, what's next? What's the next path? That's what has to be focused. That the end state. And your entire direction in the training should go toward that. Type of data in SAP, just a quick one on this. So we have three types of data in SAP. We have configuration data, we have master data, and we have transaction data. Configuration data is completely taken care by consultant. Like, as I said, there is a merger. You need to create a new company code, the legal entity. So that's consultant. You guys will do that. Configuration training. Configuration. Then we have master data, like vendors, like customers, like cost centers, all those data which is on which we can post transactions, that will be master data. So normally big companies have a separate team. If not, consultants do the master data as well. And then we have transaction data. So transaction data is something which is done by the end users in the business. Those guys take care of them, the regular business. They post an entry, they post invoice, they make payment to their own vendors. They post a JV, they run the report, they are doing the month end. And if they face any challenges, they will come to you. Hey, can you help me? I'm running the report, it is not giving me the right balance. Then consultant has to jump in and see what is the issue with the report. Is it the issue with the report, or is it really just an understanding issue which user is not able to catch? So then your role comes in. So your focus should be on configuration mostly. You have to understand transactions also. So consultant has to take care of all three normally. In projects, transaction is segregated to the users, but from learning perspective, you should also learn how to post transactions in SAP. So for you, it's all three, but your main role is configuration. Now, how transformation from traditional ECC to S/4HANA. Now, I'm using a technical term ECC here. So ECC is Enterprise Central Component, which was the release version of SAP till now, till March 2015. But from then they came up with Smart Financial, then they came up with Simple Finance, and they renamed it again to S/4HANA. So now the final product name is S/4HANA. So this is the innovation path. So 40 years SAP now ruling the market. 1970 those guys started with initial. Then they came up with R3, the three-tier architecture. And then they came up with ERP system in 2004, and then now they changed in 2015. They changed to S/4HANA. So if you see that the frequency every 10 years approximately they change. So this was a bit long, 22 years, but after that, the 12 years, then again 10 years. Okay? So this is the innovation path what SAP is following. Now, what are the benefits of S/4HANA? Why companies are running around? So number one is, it is a mandate. So benefits are something which are there, because that's why companies are going in the early stage. But at the same time, it is a mandate as well. So from long-term perspective, SAP is focusing on S/4HANA. S/4HANA is the only choice for every organization, which is on SAP at least. So benefits of S/4HANA. So number one is, there are two terms here. S/4 is separate and HANA is separate. HANA is a name of technology, High Performance Analytics Appliance. It came in 2011. It basically, you know, the database things changing. Which boost up the memory of the system. And then S/4 means suit for HANA. So now the functional changes comes in 2015. enable the high speed real time analytics. Things are real time, no bad jobs, no time lag, everything is real time. Common view of harmonized financial and management accounting. Things are merged, FI and CO. From technical standpoint, those two areas are merged together, because till now it was FI and CO. Then people were FI something, CO something, then team were doing the reconciliation. But technically, those two areas are merged now. Built-in ability to use production simulation and analysis, because everything is real-time and everything is high-speed. Simulation and analysis, what-if analysis. What if I invest $1 million here? What will be my result? All that capabilities are there in the system. On-premise, hybrid, and cloud options. I'll talk about this in the next slide, what these options are. Fiori apps. So till now it was like SAP was focused on you have to have a laptop. But now they have given the apps. If you go to Apple, you know, your Play Stores, you will see that. Or in Google Play Store. If you just type SAP, you will get a lot of apps. You can try that. Like purchase order app, like HR app, approval app. All those apps are there on the, you know. So things are now not just focused on laptops. Things are on mobile, on the go. And then optimization of business processes, event-driven with real-time execution. So as I said, it's real-time, and a lot of business processes are optimized after this innovation. So that we will learn, you know, how business processes are changed when we get into more details of the training. Now let's talk about this deployment option. This is very important. So let's understand these terms. I'll not talk about in SAP terms. I'll just talk about very simple. On-premise. You have your own data, right? You have your movies, you have your documents, you have your personal documents, official documents. You put it in the hard disk, right? Or a pen drive. You store it, and then you take care of that. That should not catch fire, right? That should not get into water if it is not waterproof. Else, you will lose your data. So you maintain it, you take the backup of that. So that's very simple with SAP as well, on-premise. Companies have hosted their servers in their own premises. They are taking care of their data. They are taking care of maintenance. If something goes wrong, they are responsible. That's on-premise. Next is on-cloud. You have a Google Drive. You just need to have ID, password. You don't worry of the space. It's giving you, I think, 10 or 15 GB for free. If you pay some money, you get more space. You keep your documents, and you don't have risk of losing. Anytime you are on mobile, you simply log into Google Drive and check your documents. You can never lose your documents. Data center is with Google. Google is taking care of their data maintenance, backups, or any servers. Anything happens, Google is taking care of. Same with SAP. SAP takes care of cloud. SAP has hosted their cloud in the data center. SAP takes care of your data. You just need to subscribe that, you know, with whatever payment they have. You subscribe and SAP takes care of data. You don't need to have backups. You don't need server space in your office. SAP takes care of that. And the third option is hybrid. Hybrid is some of your applications are on-premise and some of them are on cloud. Like you have a hard disk, you keep half your data there, and then some data you need on the go, you put it on the Google Drive. Same thing is with SAP. You have ECC on your premise, but now you buy Ariba licenses or Concur licenses last year, that's on cloud. So you have some applications on premise, some applications on cloud. So that's a hybrid logic. So in with S4HANA, with ECC, it was only on premise. But for S4HANA, there are three options. You have on-premise, you have cloud, or you can go with hybrid, with whatever way you want. Way forward. Migration. So those companies who are already on SAP today, they have to go for migration. So for those companies, that's option number one. Migration from ECC6, ESP7, that's a technical name, to S4HANA. They don't have choice. They have to migrate. SAP has given the timeline for 2023, I think, 2022 or 2023. In next 6 or 7 years, they have to migrate. For those companies who are new, they are using something else today. If they want to implement SAP, they can have a greenfield new implementation for S/4HANA. New licenses from SAP and new implementation. So if you see structure here now, here you need, in number one, you need a knowledge of S/4F0, 1, 2, and 3. Because you need to understand HANA as well as migration. In number two, you need a knowledge of S/4F0, 1, and 0.2. You don't need 3. Because there is no migration. And the third one is combining multiple systems via central finance. So this is a new option which SAP gives. You know, if those companies who are very aggressive in mergers and acquisitions, they buy a lot of companies, different other systems they have. So for them, it is very easy. You have Oracle, you have X system, you have Tally, you have SAP, 10 companies, 10 different systems. You don't need to change those systems. Keep it as it is there, those guys are using. And you implement a fresh box of S/4HANA, the second option, new implementation, and connect all those systems to S/4HANA via central finance. So that's a new technology S/4HANA came up with. So there is a standard connection, standard mappings. So data will be posted in the source system, and via mapping, it will come to the central system. So if at the management level, if company want to see the reports of their company, they can just run the report in S/4HANA system, and they will get the view of all the companies, you know, they have acquired, be it they are on any system. So for them, there is a option of central finance. So I'm currently working on two projects on central finance, both US customers. Okay. Then we have a universal general. So this is just a view. In ECC, all these were different tables, GL separate, profitability separate, management accounting separate, asset separate, ML separate. But if you see at the bottom, in the mid now, this one, universal general, this is the new table which introduced in S/4HANA, ACDOCA, ECDOCA. It means accounting document. So all those tables are merged into one. So that's what the simplification has been done. And apart from this is just one, there are a lot of things which simplification has been done. So a lot of tables being merged into one. Now companies have a more better visibility of the things, because previously it was stored in different tables. You need to combine, you have reconciliations, but now it's just stored in one. So that's known as universal journal. So with S/4HANA, you will see, listen this term again and again, universal journal. So this is how the universal journal looks like. Need for S/4HANA to organizations, as we just talked about, you know, better business advice, better corporate alignment, more effective management, lower IT cost. You know, if they go for cloud, it's lower IT cost. You just pay some money as a subscription, yearly subscription it is, and you are saving a money of your resource, you are saving a money of your space, you are saving a money of power, internet. You don't need anything in your premise. So lower IT cost. Lower cost for report generation and data reconciliation. Less cost in data reconciliation, you need less resources because things are controlled in a system itself. So S/4HANA is giving a lot of benefits. And as per SAP's latest statement, in November, I think, yeah, November or December, there are around 18,000 licenses already sold for S/4HANA apart from the completed implementation. So around 5,000 implementations are completed and 18,000 licenses are sold. So those are expected to, you know, a lot of projects have been kicked off this time, this year, and more will come. It is just, you know, we have just completed 1 month of this year. So since budgets get opened this time, so more opportunities will come in next 3-4 months for S/4HANA. All those companies who have bought license, for sure they will start projects. And as of now, there are very limited resources who have experience in the market. So companies are not looking for experience here. That's one of the advantage you guys can say. Companies are not looking for experience. They're just looking that you should have at least understanding what S/4HANA is. Because they know it very well. Just 2 years old product, they will not get experience, guys. And that to every location. It's not possible. Okay. So for now, coming to your path. If you guys don't have very new to SAP, I would not say don't have SAP knowledge. You would be reading some, you know, Google or books or all those things. If you are new to SAP, you should enter learn FICO first. That would be the right path. And then you have a choice whether you get a SEO job in the market or you want to enhance with a new technology you learn S4HANA. You have a choice there. But I think I heard in the introduction there were some people who are from different technologies, SQL or non-SAP background. For them, it is advisable to go for FICO, but S4F01 and S4F02 will also suffice. But you guys have to put some extra effort. And then you will be S4HANA consultant. And those who already are aware of SAP FICO, you should directly go to S4HANA. So that should be a learning path based on your current state where you stand today, with what expertise you have, with what knowledge you have, and what aspirations you have. Like, some people have aspirations like, I'll learn FICO and I'll get into the job. But some have, no, I'll learn, get into the new technology. I'll get one step ahead and I'll learn S4HANA. So based on your aspirations, your expectation, you have the career path here. I'll open up for question and answers. Now I think I have a few questions in the chat as well. I'm not sure if I have.
No. This is Kunal. The quick, simple question I have is like, previously we have just taken training for the FI, and we know that some point of the like SEO consulting. Do you recommend us to learn for the S4HANA, because we don't have any kind of like, you know, implementation experience on site or any project right now, but we do have some understanding for the FI and SEO kind of.
So then, if you have understanding, so you go for S4HANA 1 and 2.
Okay. Makes sense. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Any other questions, guys? Any question you have, feel free to ask, you know. Ensure that you utilize this time and all your questions will be answered.
Nitin, I would like to understand like what exactly you will be teaching in S4HANA. Like, will it be like the general ledger and the other modules that we have discussed in FICO, or accounts receivable, accounts payable, like that, or how are we going to go ahead with S4HANA?
So if you see here S4HANA course contents, so basically we will be doing the configuration, yes. So all those standard configurations by default comes. The only catch is those configurations may not be in too much detail. Like AP, we are not going to spend so many hours on AP because we have other contents. So, but yes, we will touch base all the areas.
Hi, I have a question on the certification. Do you think course 1 and 2 would be enough for certification, or do we need to take 3 also?
So, if you have to go for certification S4HANA, then this is a mandate from SAP. You have to complete all three.
All three? Okay.
Yeah.
And a follow-up question on that. So, these three are good enough for certification, or do we need to prepare anything else?
No, that's all. So, these are the if you see the term S4F0123, these are standard SAP certification books. So these are good enough to, you know, this is all standard SAP content. So if you complete this, you are good for certification.
Okay, thank you.
Any other question?
Questions in the chat.
Yeah, I'm just reading that. Do all other question module like MM or SD also S4HANA, or just only finance? So till 15-11, November 2015, it was only finance, but SAP came up with the latest release 16.10 on 31st of October 2016. So now MMSD and other things are also changed. So that's known as simple logistics, or not simple, S4HANA logistics. So all those things have changed now in last 2 or 3 months. But till 5 months back, it was only finance.
I have a question. So based on the...
I think you have issue with your mic. So you can type in. Feel free to type in the question.
Hi. So I have a question regarding this FICO, for example, being a BW and BI consultant, do I need to worry about other modules and what kind of roles I can expect once I complete the certification? So S4HANA impact, basically I'm trying to understand S4HANA impact on BW and BA space with HANA development.
Okay. So, of course, there are impact. Cubes are changed. Previously, it was, as I said, multiple tables. Now tables are limited. So impact is there. So, but you will get more deeper impact when you understand how this S4HANA works actually. What are the table structure in S4HANA? What are the configurations? How data moves? So then it will give you more insight. But yes, there are impacts on the existing BW thing.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other question from anybody? Anything you feel, that I should ask this, feel free to do that. That's what you are here for. Before you invest money, you have to ensure that, all your doubts are clear. And that's my job, that whatever course content is here, all those things I'll take care of. You will get all the study material. You will get everything, best. And of course, apart from material, I have the real-time experience. So I'll share you all those, issues comes during the different topics we talk about during the training. Any question on chat? How much CellTech can help in finding jobs after completing both the code to have their own projects? Okay. So Sam or Santhil, can you take up this question? Probably you are the right people for this.
This is Sam here. Of course, the objective here is to help you guys in placing you in the right project. That's the reason we are bringing you guys back into the session, so that you can understand where we are going with the finance and what is that you need to learn next in order to be the cream to get into the current S4HANA. So definitely we would help you out. There are a lot of projects, as Nitin said, there's a lot of projects coming up. So learning FICO migration plus S4HANA, that would really help. Without that, it would be difficult because just learning FICO alone, you'll be in a big mass of people who already is in FICO well experienced. So objective is you need to get into S4HANA finance.
So, right. So, Sam, you touched a very, very correct point. For every consultant who is FICO today, has to board a board for S4HANA because FICO will of course, in slowly and gradually it is getting obsolete now because things are coming out. And since it already have a, experienced guy sitting in, so there is less space for the new people. But S4HANA is something is giving you opportunity that even if you have less experience, you get trained, well-versed yourself with the system, with the terminologies, and ensured the more hard work you do in the training, the more easily you get the job because there are no experienced guy in the market. I am experienced in SAP FICO, but in S4HANA, I just have 1.5 years of experience because that's the age of the product. So you will get quick entry here. And a lot of projects, as I said, are coming in.
And to add to what Sam has said, this is Senthil. To add to what Sam has said, Gopi, we also have a lot of implementation partners that are currently, implementing projects. So we would do everything in our capacity to assist towards the placement. I think and it is your duty to kind of upgrade your skills to what is most required in the market, which is S/4HANA, from what Nitin and Sam is saying. So once you get to that, and once you have that skill set, I think it should be very easy for us to kind of be able to assist and place you.
Okay. Any other question? So, okay, we have, can we get trained in S/4HANA with no knowledge in FICO? Yes. So as I said, S/4HANA F1 and 2 are for those people, you know. If you have very less or little knowledge, so get into S4 of 1 and 2. Don't get into 3 so early. 1 and 2 are the right choice. I am fresh in SAP. Only certification is enough to apply for the job without showing 5 years. So that's what I said, Ashwak. FICO, 5 years, 10 years, everybody, you, people are there in the market. If somebody asks me, I have 10 years in SAP, FICO. So people are there in the market. S/4HANA, people are not there. So that's an advantage at this point, you know, this year, early, by end of this year, you will get. By next year, you know, the product will be old. It was launched in 2015. 15, 16, 17, by the time this year ends, people will have 3-4 years experience and they will start getting projects. So this is the right time, you know, it's just 1.5 to, you know, less than 2 years old product. It came in March 2015. So it's the right time to get into this S/4HANA thing. Yes, so dates are tentative. We are planning to start batch from next week and timings are, you know, as of now, we can work upon timings. I think I put somewhere on the slide. That's the proposed based on my bandwidth and availability, and this may change, you know, this keeps on changing as I get time from different projects. This keeps on changing. So it's like Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday or Sunday, 7:30 p.m. CST or 8 p.m. CST. So this keeps on changing, don't worry about it, and we are flexible enough to, you know, accommodate your existing work schedules into this, so don't worry about it. I am working on general accounting almost 12 years without FICO. I can start S/4HANA. Yes, of course, if you have accounting knowledge, that's well and good. You are good for 1 and 2, S/4HANA 1 and 2. Any other question? Any last minute question you guys have? Feel free to put it on the chat, unmute yourself, speak up. Clear all your doubts. But I'm telling you, this is one of the, you know, latest industry trend. If you go to check on Google, you will see how S/4HANA is performing and what is the scope in the market for jobs.
Hi, Nitin. A question related to the duration. So how long it will take to complete all three parts of the course usually?
Okay. So hold on. Okay. So it's individual, if you know, it depends how you are planning to register. If it is individual, it is 35. If you take 1 and 2, as some people are talking about, you know, they just want to learn, they are new, it's 60. If you want all three together, 1, 2, and 3, it's around 90 hours. Which includes,
okay.
Yeah, 1, 2 plus migration, 3.
And I saw the starting time as 7:30 CST, but how long the duration is, like 2 hours a day or something?
So normally we plan it around 2-2.5 hours, but it's not a hard and fast. You know, sometimes what happened, I'm like initially, you know, you guys join the class, it's sometimes it's over for you. So we end up in 2 hours or 1.5 hour. Sometimes it is, everybody feel interesting when you get into the class, you know, after 4 or 5 classes. So then people take interest. So then, like configuration. So then you guys do it quickly. So then we can extend it up to 3 hours maximum, 3-3.5 max. So we don't have classes like, you know, 6 or 7 hours so long, short classes, and so that, you know, you get sufficient time to learn what you get in the class to practice that, you know, when you go back at least. And there is a gap in days, like Tuesday, Thursday. So you have next day to at least practice something, you know, to go into system, to read the books, so to come up with the questions. Normally, the standard duration is 2 hours each class. That's what we take.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so I just want to understand if the career path becomes strictly IT-oriented. You know, my career is 15 years old and I use SAP. So if you learn all these things, it's not only SAP IT driven, you can also be a finance person. You can all rather be a business consultant. Like when you have experience, get into these projects, you know, you don't always, you know, when you have experience of 5 or 7, 10 years in SAP, you always don't just go and configure the system. You advise, you kind of work as a business consultant, you work end-to-end business processes, work with the CFOs, with the CIOs, you know, with top levels to understand how their business works, how to design your processes.
There's
so salary range, you know.
Yeah. Go ahead, please, go ahead.
So salary range, you know, it depends. As I said, more you invest in your training in terms of time, in terms of learning, in terms of, you know, more reading, you have more opportunities, you have more, you will get more salary. Depends on, you know, it depends on various factors like what experience you currently have, how much you learn, what kind of project you get, are you working away from home, are you working, you know, in your local town, it all depends on that. But in terms of S4HANA, I can tell you around, you know, the rates which are there is like $100 an hour or so, $100, $120, $130. That's a very pretty standard rate it is going on. Any other question, guys? So in case you have any more question, you know, we have a contact number here, email ID. So feel free to reach Celtech Academy for any of your queries even after this session. You know, you will get answered to that. You can have an email ID as well as the phone number. Let me see if there is any question. Okay. I know some folks are here already, FICO, but you will go through FICO first before. No. So Gopi, we are not going to FICO first and then going to S4HANA. So these are two different topics. FICO is separate class, S4HANA is separate class. It's not something we are merging together. Thank you, Radhika. Thank you so much for your compliment. I appreciate that.
Nathan, thanks very much. It was an excellent presentation.
Thank you so much.
It's pretty clear for the freshers as well as whoever attended FICO training as well as experienced finance consultants here, whoever joined the session. So thanks everyone for attending this session, and tomorrow our back office staffs would reach you and talk to you guys and figure out, also explain about the start date of the course, and you can work with her, and once everything is organized, the class would start as quick as possible. Again, thanks for everyone who have joined the classes.
So Arun, you have a contact number in the email ID. You were asking for fees, so please connect with on these numbers and email ID.
Thank you, Nitin, Sam, and Santil. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Thank you so much, guys. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.